friends, it's so great to have another trailer chock full of stuff for us to discuss. And this, you know, thank goodness Marvel's been having a bit of a rough time of it lately. And it seems like this is the kind of movie that would kick off the summer movie season, which is exactly what it's going to do. Guardians of the Galaxy established the first weekend of August release date, which nobody, except for the first Suicide Squad, so it was funny that James Gunn, went over to do that second film. So much funny stuff going on these days. But anyway, then for the second movie, got the prime spot of kicking off the summer movie season. And for its third entry, the last for James Gunn, and the last for this lineup, for this team, it's going to kick off the summer movie season as well. That's right. Multiple characters, I hear, are going to die. That's right. You can tell from this trailer that it's pretty sad, although I have some theories as to what might happen to Rocket. He might not necessarily die. I'll discuss them with you. But speaking of what's going to happen, I heard that they filmed multiple deaths so that it wouldn't leak who was killed, so that only James Gunn and a few select people would know in the editing room. And then as soon as it plays for anybody, it would leak on the internet anyway. But at least, you know, there'd be like as much secrecy as possible these days. The team's a little bit too big, to be honest with you. But so I'm ready for a bit of a new lineup. A number of you are wondering, why is Zoe Saldana not dressed like the rest of the group? Well, it's because she's a Ravager. She's a Ravager. And that's all I'm going to say on that. Although she's not wearing, she seems to be wearing red on the cover of this, this poster. But in the trailer, she's green. She's all green, you know. Boy, there's a very cool shot of her in this trailer. So let's go over this. There is, as I said, plenty to discuss. I hope this movie's long. All right. So we start out. Look, it's like a tape deck. And, you know, it's scratched in there. It's like, this is like when you, I don't know, some people like this, but I never forgot my friend who doodled on her calculator and regretted it and was like, I ruined it. it's not all sparkling and clean anymore. So this is like an amp that's, a player that's seen some days, I guess, kind of like this trilogy in this crew. And there they are on the new ship. This is the, that's the Bowie, which was actually introduced in the holiday special. So they started out with the Milano, moved on to the Benatar, as in Pat Benatar, and now this is the Bowie, aka David Bowie. And considering David Bowie's image and music in that IMAX film that actually recently came out, which seemed a little bit like a Guardians of the Galaxy movie, that is probably the best name they've come up with for a ship yet, because if anyone's going to go flying across the stars, it's David Bowie. I'm misting up already, actually. Woo! Woo! All right, that actually made me the saddest of all. All right, because of my poor David Bowie. All right, so anyway, this is funny to me. This looks like an amalgam of Earth cities. Like, it seems like they got or maybe it's an actual city. But it seems like it's got, like, it's not New York City. That's not the tip of New York City, but it seems to have, like, a Statue of Liberty figure there. I wonder who that is a statue of. I hope we do a flyby, and I hope it's a good joke. Or a big reveal. I feel this might be tied into the High Evolutionary. So we first come in and it looks like they're just landing in a normal suburban neighborhood. And it's like, Marvel, stop picking on the suburbs. You know, WandaVision and all that. So they come out and they're wearing their new uniforms. Now in the comic, these are the Annihilation uniforms. And I gotta say, they do look kind of cool from like the chest up, but they are not flattering to the midsection. I'd be like, whew, who tailored these things? I feel particularly bad for poor Karen Gillan. We'll talk about the really cheap VFX in a moment. Oh, but just look at her arm. I mean, she's wearing a rubber glove for sure, man. An elegant rubber glove for balls and parties. It goes all the way up. But the logo's different. The logo is different. So, because you might be wondering, who made these guys so official? They seem to be an offshoot of the Nova Corps. Because it looks like a combination of the Ravager logo, which is similar to the Annihilation comic outfit logo, but they've layered on the Nova Corps logo on top of that. So I think that's very interesting. Maybe they got a little bit of an operating budget. I mean, that sweet ship certainly seems to say that's the case. So that's their new look. Groot, I was shocked at how bad Groot looked in the holiday special. I thought they just cheaped out because it was the special, but of course they would spend more money on him in the movie. That just looks like a dude walking around Disneyland. I'm really surprised. Although, interestingly, he does look more like Vin Diesel. I mean, now I'm like, at least tell me that's Vin Diesel in the suit. So that's pretty shocking. That's pretty freaking shocking. I don't know what happened. I mean, it's Disney. They just have buckets upon buckets of money. They're hiding it from Scarlett Johansson. So put some of that into the VFX here. So it's revealed that these are animal people. And at first I was just, you know, thinking, that guy's a little hard to look at. Let's move on to the next people. Woo, all right. So I was just at first like, oh, it's Real Life Zootopia or Richard Scary. These guys are a little scary. This is a little bit more the Island of Dr. Moreau type situation. And that's interesting because the High Evolutionary, our villain, is kind of like Dr. Moreau. I think this movie's going to be a lot about evolution, obviously, but probably about like what's ideal and what's best and at the core, what's at the heart or soul of a person, as in the Soul Gem, as in Adam Warlock. I can see it all kind of starting to come together already, and I hope it is indeed this well thought out and written. So anyway, I think that these might be an experiment of the High Evolutionary, and maybe this is what starts them on the path of this movie. They're checking this out, and Rocket Raccoon, who looks like he could hang out with these people, animals, that lion there actually looks pretty cool on the left. Maybe he should look at a house. Maybe he should see what's on the market. But, you know, he, of course, is more animal than these individuals. But I think there's probably a correlation. So they're like, oh, you want to play ball? Oh, right in the face. But I got to tell you, that happens with people, too. I'd be like, don't be so upset. This happens all the time, kid. Why don't you put your arms up? Why don't you just let yourself get smacked in the head? So, but, you know, it's not looking good. And they feel they start throwing rocks at them. And you can see Nebula put her arm up. Hold on, where was that shot? Let me find it. Yeah. When I saw her fingers, that's what first I was like, boy, that's cheap VFX. That's just a rubber glove that she's gone on. And it's not even a particularly well-fitting rubber glove, because if those were my electronic advanced arm fingers, I'd be like, I need a refund. They look like they kind of melted on there. What it really is the glove doesn't fit properly. So that's pretty surprising to me. It's a small but glaring problem in an otherwise very nice trailer. All right. So he's very sad. He's doing a Tony Stark. He's looking out at space, being like, man, just looking at my own, talk about my own soul and heart. That's how I feel, what I'm looking at. We don't know what he's sad about. Of course, he's sad about, you know, losing Gamora in the Guardians of the Galaxy holiday special. And he's going to be a bit of a bummer for this movie, too, because he feels really bad about it. Now, by the way, somebody in the comment section was like, how is Gamora still alive? And it's like, weren't you paying attention during Endgame? So just as a refresher, you know, they had time travel in Endgame as well. An earlier version of her before she went through the, you know, redefining, you know, romantic relationship with Peter Quill, which changed her as a person and made her less interesting as a character. She came into this situation. She came into this time. You know, she moved up to this timeline. So she's like an earlier version of Gamora who skipped over her death. You know, Doc Brown would be having a field day with this situation. So that's kind of what's going on. But so she never fell in love with Peter Quill. As Nebula said, it's a surprising relationship. It takes like certain circumstances for it to work out. And it seems that ship has sailed. So there's a great shot of Mantis. Mantis is so great. Mantis and Nebula are my favorites. Although, as I said, I got high hopes for Gamora. You know, I hope James Gunn does her right before he leaves. I can't quite tell what's reflected there. I wonder if those are some of the other animals. That looks like it might be Cosmo in the lower left corner. Curse this out-of-focus reflection. So look, now this is the High Evolutionary, I believe, reaching for a baby Rocket Raccoon. Oh, he's so cute. Look at him there. He's remembering. That's so Guardians with these suits. And they're hideous. as is this, you know, the fun tone of Guardians of the Galaxy. Like, wouldn't it be funny if they had hideous but yet very cheerful suits? And you're like, yes, here they are. And, you know, the production, the costume design department knocked it out of the park. Now, I feel this is the High Evolutionary's base of operations, which is fascinating to me, because he's someone who plays with organic matter, and that looks like distorted organic matter. It's really disgusting and scary, and I think that's a great choice for this character. Talk about an island of Dr. Moreau. All right, so there's Gamora. There's Gamora, and she's, you know, I wonder who's in that picture. I couldn't find an example of when they took a Polaroid picture in the past. Is it Peter? Is it Nebula? Is it the whole group? Does she miss everybody? But I like that it's a Polaroid, of course, because talk about time travel, Peter's still stuck in the 1980s to a large degree. I think this is the best we've seen Zoe Saldana look in these movies yet. I think she looks really great. I think her hair looks super cool. It looks really pretty, but yet also tough. Like, she means business. She doesn't have time for a blowout. She doesn't need a blowout. I love it. She looks phenomenal. And as you can see, they've gone with green with her suit. But I think because she's the Ravager leader, that looks like the Ravager logo on her arm. Alrighty, so there they are. So you can see this looks like the same location that they had in the Guardians of the Galaxy holiday special. Although in this, you know, Peter, boy, he's having a rough time. First he was sad at Christmas. Now he looks to be totally unconscious. So there he is. I wasn't sure if that was him at first. You know, he lost all of his physical definition. You know, he became famous for how he's working out. And he just, like, gave up on it, which I guess is very Peter Quill-like. So I guess it really works with the character. So there's our lineup. Look how bad Groot looks. And there's Cosmo, who isn't really shown in this trailer, which I think was a good choice. I think they got to be careful with Cosmo. I'm a little nervous about how Cosmo is going to work out. And the team here doesn't have their uniforms on. So, you know, maybe they're like, we don't like working for a larger organization. Welcome to the club. So let's see. And he's like, and he says, I'm tired of running. I had to do it. All right. Yeah, look at that. It looks like a colon. It looks like a certain hole. That's funny. You know, I got it. I got the joke. Blah. All right. So there's the High Evolutionary. I was like, dude, do you know that what your space station looks like? So look, he's got a human running in a hamster wheel, because that's the kind of guy he is. Up is down, left is right. Humans are animals, and animals are humans. So he's the High Evolutionary. This is Chukwudi. I'm sure I'm mispronouncing the name, Awuji, from Peacemaker, James Gunn's DC project. And he found himself in a Marvel movie. Although I gotta say, with the costume and the space theming, it's very similar to Kang. And they're back-to-back villains. And I don't understand why you would do that to poor Kang, because Jonathan Majors looks so amazing. All right, so very interesting stuff about the High Evolutionary. So basically, he is the Mr. Sinister of the Marvel Cosmic, if you know your X-Men. He is fascinated with genetics, and he has the ability to evolve and devolve life forms, including himself. Apparently in the comics, he ran across Jack Russell very early on in his life. He's become immortal, so he's been around for quite a long time. And Jack Russell, of course, is Werewolf by Night. And I guess I would love to think that that gave him the idea to create humanoid animals. Wouldn't that be interesting? Oh, I would love that. And that would make sense that they took the time to introduce Werewolf by Night before this movie. Oh, if only Marvel connected the dots like this still. They used to do that in earlier days, but these days they're in such a rush that they don't quite do it to the degree that they should. He also spent some time at Wondagore Mountain, by the way, and was responsible for Wanda and Pietro getting adopted, but I don't know if they're going to go there. And he also had a group called the New Men, which were his human animals, his humanoid animals. And we're gonna talk about that. He also had a run-in with Adam Warlock, who, of course, is a major character here, and we'll talk about that. We'll pick up with that when we see Adam Warlock. So there. Look at that shot of Gamora. And she really knows how to find her light. Tyra Banks would be proud. She's like, you know, like right in the tunnel. She's like, okay, let's stop here. Highlights the hair beautifully. Smize, but I'm upset. I'm smizing. You know, my eyes say smize. My face says, I'm going to F you up. I'd love to see Gamora finally F someone up, because that's like her supposed to be her whole deal. She's never done it. All right. She's been listening to headphones and doing kissy faces. Come on, Gamora. All right. So that reminds me, by the way, of Andor. I'm like, don't you guys compare notes over there at the House of Mouse? So that looks like the High Evolutionary's lab, maybe. And I don't think Drax is going to make it. I mean, Dave Bautista was like, he basically told us. He's like, I'm done. So, and I think he's pulling a Harrison Ford Han Solo where he's like, and I'm not coming back. So could you please make that so that if that's the case so I can't come back? And it looks like he's taking a blaster to the chest. I feel bad for Mantis. What's she going to do without him? All right. Gravity's turned off, as you can see there. All right. So, be careful where you step, everybody. Because I think this is a colon. That looks like ribs, though, kind of. I wonder what this once was. That's kind of sad. All right. And now look at Rocket. You can see, like, I don't know if that was added on or if he's missing fur on both sides of his face, but I think, you know, it's not looking good for him, and he's all teary-eyed, and that looks like the bottom of a cage for an animal, and he's surrounded by food pellets. What's happening to him? I have maybe kind of a theory. We'll see. I mean, I think de-evolution is something to think about here. I mean, we'll see. I haven't heard anything about this to confirm, but we'll see if they play with that. Could someone turn him back into a raccoon? Would he want that? A simpler life. Now, I'm wondering who Peter Quill is. I think this might be that planet with the human animals. And that when they first come there and they're like, what's going on here? And maybe this is what leads them to the High Evolutionary. Because there's no sky in the High Evolutionary's base of operations. He's in the solar system. So this has to be, I think, on that planet. So, I think they've been doing some stuff that obviously has made Peter very angry. Oh, all right. Groot looks so horrible. I can't believe the production executive who was like, yes, let's do that. I'd be like, I don't care how much money it saves us. It's embarrassing. The guy in that suit must be embarrassed. No one can see his face, so look at that arm. Oh, it annoys me so much. That's a cool shot of him. He looks great. He doesn't look that alien to me, though. I guess they were tired. I guess they don't want to pull a Gamora on him. But look, there's his blade with blood on it. Oh, you monster. And oh, that's sad. I gotta say, Chris Pratt can act. He's very good at delivering the emotion. He looks extremely sad. I don't want to see the reverse shot of what's going on here. Oh, it is very sad. All right. So everyone was so happy to see, not just because this is an otter, but this is Lilo, Rocket Raccoon's love interest in the comics. So we'll see if they explore that here. I mean, we all love otters, but it's a little weird to think of loving an otter in that way. But, you know, very cute, very adorable. This really does remind me a lot of Zootopia, which, of course, also featured otters. I wonder if Lila will rub her hands together like those otter videos. So adorable. All right. So there's another friend. Some kind of weird, I don't know if that's even an octopus or what's going on there. I don't like that. There's Adam Warlock. All right. So Adam Warlock is supposed to be a perfect specimen of man. So that's why there was a rumor going around that Zac Efron might be cast in the role. And some people were not too kind about Will Poulter and whether or not he has, you know, classic traditional good looks when he was cast, which I thought was a little mean because I think, if you've seen him in some of his more recent work, I think he could pull it off. But I don't think that the costume and the hair and makeup team are really helping him. I think they're working against him, quite frankly, because I've seen Will Poulter look much better than this. I'd be like, he looks better when he showed up to work today. What are you guys doing? He's supposed to be a golden glistening god. He does not look like that. Now let's talk about Adam Warlock. All right, so what's that smack in the middle of his forehead? Well, usually in the comic, it's an Infinity Stone. It's specifically the Soul Gem, which he actually gets from the High Evolutionary. Fascinating. Now, of course, in the MCU, he's created by Ayesha of the Sovereign People, played by Princess Diana, aka Elizabeth Debicki, to take out the Guardians of the Galaxy. And I'd heard a rumor that he was going to be, you know, very, you know, infantilized because he's just born, basically, and he really wants to do good by his mommy. He doesn't look that way in this trailer, though, so let's see. Will Poulter could do that quite well. He's got the traditional powers of being an enhanced human, and also, because he's a cosmic character, he can manipulate cosmic energy, as you can see him doing in some cool shots from the comics. He's been a member of the Guardians of the Galaxy team, and I wouldn't be surprised if he ends up being a member by the end of this movie, because they're going to have more than one opening. And also, because of the soul gem, he can devolve animals back to what they started out as. So if, you know, Rocket maybe wanted to go back to his origins, although, again, I couldn't see him making that choice, you know, Adam Warlock could oblige or maybe he could fix what the High Evolutionary does if he takes things further somehow. But, you know, we'll see. Is Adam Warlock, you know, and how does the High Evolutionary get involved? Is he involved? Does Ayesha come to the High Evolutionary for help? Because, of course, the High Evolutionary specialty is, you know, genetic manipulation, you know, the evolution of life. And, you know, again, as I said, Adam Warlock is supposed to be peak. He's supposed to be peak. He's supposed to be a god, you know, as a perfect specimen. Now, speaking of specimens, you might have also noticed that he's got a lot of similarities to Vision, including maybe an Infinity Stone smack in the middle of his forehead. That looks weird. It looks like it's almost underneath his skin poking out instead of placed on top of it, which I think is very interesting. Looks a little bit more Frankenstein-y than what's going on with Vision. But it's weird to have two of these. And in fact, like Vision, there's even an alternate version of Adam Warlock called the Magus from the comics, which is a darker version of him. So that's really weird to me. I'm like, well, why don't we just maybe stick Vision in this role, to be honest. I don't know, maybe Peter Quill will die and they'll need Adam Warlock to lead the team, as Adam Warlock has done in some versions of the comic. So we'll see. I think Will Poulter is interesting. He's not a great Adam Warlock, but he is a good replacement maybe for Chris Pratt going forward. Also, I think Will Poulter is like the James Gunn version he's like a dude's version of like the perfect man. Like if you were to ask a dude like, you know, Chris Pratt or James Gunn, who's the ideal male specimen, it would be probably Will Poulter, because they have different criteria. Like who do you want to hang out with and play video games with all day and talk movies? Will Poulter! So I think that would be funny if maybe they discussed that. But it's, again, tying into all this stuff, so I think that's really interesting. But yeah, it's very similar to Vision. It seems to be like Vision dressed like Iron Man, quite frankly. Although, hold on, he's got a cape too, like Vision. See? There he is, rocking the cape here. I wonder what happens to it. I bet Nebula rips that right off his body. So that's crazy. He looks like he's wearing Thor's costume a little bit there. They got to stop making all the MCU costumes look exactly the same. Also, I'd be like, Will Poulter, you're supposed to be the ideal specimen of humanity. Don't make that face. Please. You got to have better facial control, man. And who's he wailing on? Nebula. Oh, yeah, she's about to get that cape. Look at her. Oh, what is that? That thing is a turtleneck? Oh. So what, she's got a sweater on that has a glove knitted into it? What's going on here? What? Why would she cover up? Does her metal arm get cold? Is it to save money? That's fascinating. All right. I love Nebula. All right. So yes, I think Mantis is in the same room wherever that very sad thing is happening with Peter Quill. And she's sad too. So there's the team. Everybody, you can see Gamora has a different outfit on. Who's that following them? That looks like some kind of weird, almost to some degree looks like Baby Groot. Grogu. Grogu and Groot sound very similar, actually. There's Groot. I was hoping maybe he got whittled down again and he would grow back better than this. But there's some kind of creature following them, which is kind of adorable. All right. So speaking of Groot, there he is, and his giant ridiculous midsection at least unfurls into multiple arms for guns, multiple vines for guns. And here they're having a shootout in that same space where we saw earlier. So I think that's the Zootopia planet. But that's the same, by the way, that's the same move that Peter Quill, of course, did with Groot. Adorable. And so there we go. Guardians of the Galaxy, Volume 3, baby! And we have this great stinger, which I think is very funny. You know, like I said, I don't always think Drax's jokes are good, but when they're good, they're very good. So he's like, I'm going to kill one guy. And then he's like, it's great. I thought it was very funny. So I think this looks really solid. I think it looks really good. Right now, we're tied. Most of you liked the first Guardians of the Galaxy, but didn't like the second. I'm the opposite. Didn't like the first, enjoyed the second. So let's see if we can all like the third. All right, so what did you think? What are your theories? What did you think of the new characters? Share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.